So what I have here is a piece of the Allende meteorite. And this rock fell to Earth in early 1969. Why is that important? It's important because this meteorite was recording what was going on 4.5 billion years ago. In fact, there are grains of material that are the leftovers of the formation of the solar system. So the object must have seen these different conditions in the early solar system, recording the composition, pressure, and temperature. And we can understand what those conditions were because we understand the chemistry. We can decode the histories of things from the thermodynamic evidence in the rock itself. I'm Denton Ebel. I'm the curator of meteorites at the American Museum of Natural History. Right now, we're in the meteorite collection area. We have cabinets, drawers full of meteorites. And one of the things we do with meteorites is make them available to researchers around the world for research, both about planets and also about the earliest solar system. What's exciting to me is that chemical thermodynamics remains central to all of that. Thermodynamics is the understanding of how matter and energy behave in nature or in the laboratory. When you're making electronics, when we're smelting steel, we use the science of thermodynamics. Chemical thermodynamics is the study of energy and the stability of solids, liquids, gases in terms of composition, pressure, and temperature. How does heat transfer from one thing to another? The science of thermodynamics allows us to predict the behavior of materials without doing an experiment. We all experience chemical thermodynamics in our lives. We live on Earth near the triple point, the point at which liquid water, ice, and steam can coexist. When you boil water, you're creating an equilibrium between the steam just above your pot of water and the water below it. At one atmosphere of pressure, that equilibrium is at 100 degrees centigrade, which allows you to boil pasta. If you go to the top of a Sierra Nevada and you try and boil pasta there, it could take you a long time because the water's boiling at a lower temperature because the pressure is significantly lower. This is thermodynamics. We can predict the temperature at which water will boil at any pressure. Extend that concept. Chemical laws, physical laws operate, as far as we know, the same way everywhere in the universe. So the thermodynamics that we use to understand the formation of the minerals and meteorites is based on 100 plus years of experiments in laboratories to understand the behavior of the different elements. We can test ideas about what happened in the early solar system, how small solid objects formed and then mixed together and grew to bigger objects. It allows us to take the composition of the solar system, which is essentially the sun, and predict what minerals would condense, would come from gas to solid form. And in fact, our understanding of how elements behave in nature is driven in part by the understanding of meteorites themselves. So we see in this piece of Allende, little round things of different kinds. These round objects, there's one there, there's one, that are called chondrules. Their average size is about 500 microns, maybe five times the width of a human hair. Chondrules are droplets of once-molten rock, and they are the most abundant component of most of the meteorites that fall to Earth. We can put these under a microscope, and we can take images. We can, in fact, map the elements so we can see where all the magnesium is and where it's distributed, the calcium, the aluminum, the silicon. And what we've been doing in my group for years now is very carefully measuring how much of each material is in each meteorite. Just simply measuring how much stuff of different kinds is in a rock is a very important thing to understand the major differences between the classes of meteorites. And as our understanding improves, we use the rocks to constrain astrophysical theories. And this is where the science of thermodynamics comes in, to say this is what could have happened and this probably is not what happened. How did we heat material in the early solar system? How far out from the early, early sun was there enough heat to melt rocks? How long did it last? These are the kinds of questions that we look at the meteorites for answers for. The ability to combine chemistry with physical dynamical theories allows you to think about what might have happened and what might be happening in solar systems elsewhere. How are places today forming planets? And why are some planets different than others? That's the Holy Grail.